This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video.
Oh, hey guys! What are you doing here?
Oh, we saw this video of Dude Perfect doing trick shots with these plungers and we had to try it.
Ah, cool! I wanna try that too! Yeah!
Damn it, Jordy! Always the same.
So what now, Janik?
I got the solution, Lorenzo. I'll get him. Let's go.
You're doing great, Janik.
Watch out, Janik, you're gonna
Well, that happened.
Hello, it's Janik here for CineCam.net. Or is it .net? Anyways, welcome to another Copycat Friday, a series where we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. And this week we again took some inspiration out of Dude Perfect's latest video, the plunger trick shots. And well, at first we thought like, this looks a little bit easy and stupid, but once we tried it ourselves, like, whew! We didn't make one shot. Now, talking about shots, our sponsor Storyblocks Video has a huge online library full of high quality stock video clips up to 4K resolution. They are constantly expanding the library and have a wide range of After Effects templates, backgrounds, transitions, and so much more. And the cool thing about Storyblocks is that you only pay one price per year and can download an unlimited amount of assets you want. If you want to start downloading these video assets, go ahead and click in the first link in the description below. Now, luckily for the effect that we are going to do, we don't need to throw around plungers to make them stick. Because today we are going to climb the wall with the plungers. And let's be honest, that's at least as cool as the trick shots of Dude Perfect. For this effect, we are going to use a different technique than you normally should. In normal situations, if you want to climb a wall, you can either really climb a wall with some safety ropes and a harness, or you can use a green screen. Well, for this effect, we wanted to do something different, and instead went for some perspective and blending. And yes, you heard me, we're going to blend ourselves onto a wall. Of course, the blending method has some restrictions, which I'm going to talk about later on. But you can easily use a green screen instead of the blending method. The principle of using the perspective stays exactly the same. Now let's start by finding a wall that we want to climb. Place your camera on a tripod and create the frame that you want. The first thing to keep in mind here is that when you place your camera far away from the wall, you're also going to need to film from a higher perspective for the climbing shot. So don't go too far away from the wall. Also, try to find a relatively clean and light wall, like the one we have here, or a concrete one. This will make the blending in post-production much easier. And this is one of the restrictions I was talking about. Because if the wall has too much texture or is too dark, then the blending wouldn't work. Okay, now that you've filmed your wall, it's time for the second shot. But before you can take the shot, there are a few steps you need to do.
So we are at the store now, ready to buy some white cloth and plungers. Let's go.
I love going to the store. See snacks
and it's almost 10 o'clock, so I need my snack.
Sneaky. M&M's.
My climbing gear.
First, you are going to need this white cloth. We are using white because we need this color to blend it afterwards. You can lay this on the floor, as this is going to be your fake wall. Now let's look at the lighting of the first shot. It's super important that the two shots will match in lighting, otherwise the effect will look fake. So when setting up the white cloth in the second shot, keep in mind from where the light comes in your first shot. You can do the setup in the same location as your wall. This will make it easier to match the lighting. But if it's too windy or the weather changed, you can also recreate the lighting with some film lights indoor. Next, we need some reference points for the perspective. So on your camera, go to the playback and take the first shot. Now with a water-based marker, we are going to draw some reference lines which we can use to align the perspective of the second shot with the first one. And now it's time to match your perspective. Take out the plungers and let your actor lay on the white cloth. If we now compare the setup with the original wall, we can see that the actor is horizontal and the wall is vertical. To make these two match, we need to rotate our setup and the actor with 90 degrees so that they stand up and can be matched with the original one. But then the actor can't fake climb and the effect won't work. So the solution for that is that we rotate the camera with 90 degrees. You can place your camera on a tripod or go handheld. But I don't really recommend handheld as your shot needs to be super still. Now it's time to use the reference lines. Try moving around your setup to match the perspective. Keep in mind that you're also going to need to film from a height. The height depends on how far the wall was in your first shot. Once you have found the right height, angle and framing, you can film your shot. Let your actor do some fake climbing and that's it. Oh yeah, before I forget, try not to wear any light clothes when doing this. Otherwise you will blend out your actor and that isn't what we are trying to do here. Okay, I think we have everything now to start with the post-production. And it's quite easy from now on. Inside Premiere Pro, take the shot of the wall and place it on track number 1. Now take the climbing shot and place it on track number 2. Go to the effects control panel and within the opacity property, take the pen tool to create a mask. You can now create a mask around your actor, but still within the white cloth. So the only thing that is left is your actor surrounded by the white. The next thing you can do now is scale and position the actor on the wall. Once that is done, you can go back to the effects control panel and within the opacity property, you can change the blending mode to darker color. After you have done this, the white will be removed, but the actor will still be visible. The thing with this blending mode is that it will move everything that is white and that leans to white. So if your actor has some lighter exposed parts, these will also be removed. Luckily, we can fix that with some color grading. Open up the Lumetri color panel, and if you can't find it, go up to the window menu on top and search for the Lumetri color between the options. Now select the climbing shot and let's prevent that the parts of the actor are being removed. In the basic correction tab, we can start with lowering the highlights and the whites so that the part of the actor that were removed come back. But by doing this, your actor will become darker and won't match with the wall. So if needed, you can also increase the shadows to make your actor more bright. Normally, you would do this with the exposure slider, but by increasing this slider, you'll again start biting into the actor. So this can only be done with the shadow slider. However, when you do this, the actor's shadows will lose their punch and will become flat. So to solve this, decrease the black slider and darken the shadows. And that is all there is to it to create this awesome effect. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you learned something new and enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching and don't forget that notification bell for a weekly dose of CineCom. Thank you so much, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
No, we have a problem.